Benjamin Franklin once famously flew a kite in a thunderstorm to demonstrate the electricity generated during thunderstorms, which flow along the kite's string, and allowed Benjamin Franklin to see a spark when he touched an attached metal key. Whether underground or hung on electrical towers, conductive wires transfer the electricity used for so many devices and appliances in a similar way. Unless you're getting some electricity wirelessly from a Tesla coil, of course. The one in my basement let me upload this video. Yet, when how it all works out is considered, there's some really cool physics going on, which has been compiled by physicists over many years, and it all starts out with conductors, which already have charge flowing through them. With Benjamin Franklin's kite, water soaked the hemp string, and any ions dissolved in the water, like salt, served as the medium for the electricity to move along. Other good conductors, like copper or silver, have loosely bound outer electrons that move between the conductor's atoms, even without a current attached. When there is a current attached, this electron movement lets the flood of electrons coming from the power source move along these atoms as well, only now there's a flow of electrons away from the power source, since the higher concentration of negatively charged electrons push on one another. But if the metal has impurities, the impurities get in the way of the electron flow and do not allow electrons to move as freely. The same is true when heat is applied, which makes electrons collide more, not allowing them to flow as easily. Semiconductors, however, like silicon, with certain impurities added, actually work better with more heat, which is why they are used so much in high temperature computer chips, while insulators like sulfur hang on to their electrons tightly and therefore will stop an electric current, which is why insulators are used around conductive wires. The type of current attached to conductive wires matters too. While direct current just passes the electrons through a closed system towards the positive end, alternating current constantly changes the current's direction and doesn't need a closed system for current flow. Alternating current is used to bring power to homes for its greater safety. Additionally, electric current will generate a magnetic field spinning counterclockwise with regard to the direction of the current, and this property allows electric stoves and magnetic rail trains or rail guns to operate. Superconductors even have zero resistance when cooled to low temperatures, making them the best possible conductors of electric current. All in all, the conductive properties of electricity have found their way into countless essential parts of our lives.